गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप ऑल आर यू डूइंग एंड होप ऑल आर यू गुड एंड डूइंग योर स्टडी वेल. लास्ट टाइम वी हैव बीन डिस्कस्ड अबाउट दी एनर्जी डेंसिटी ऑफ अ पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर. नाउ टुडे हियर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द कम्बिनेशन ऑफ ए कैपेसिटर्स. सो फर्स्ट कम्बिनेशन इज सीरीज कम्बिनेशन. Series combination of a capacitors. So here two or more capacitors are said to be in series whenever these are connected from end to end. Or one more definition for the series is two or more capacitors are said to be in series whenever they store same charge or they are at the same charge. So here we have been considered three capacitors having capacitance C1, C2 and C3 and let them, these are connected in series, and let V1, V2, V3 be the potential drop across the capacitor having capacitance C1, C2 and C3. If we assumed Cs be the equivalent capacitance or net capacitance of a series combination and V be the applied potential, then according to principle of conservation of energy, V must be equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. That is the potential drop across the capacitor C1, C2 and C3 or V1, V2 and V3, that must be equal to, their sum must be equal to the net potential V. Therefore, net potential V must be equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now, as we know, in series, charge remains same. Therefore, charge stored through each capacitor is taken as Q. Then, V must be equal to Q by Cp, and V1 must be equal to Q by C1, V2 must be equal to Q by C2, and V3 must be equal to Q by C3. Now we can take Q common from here. You can see we have been taken Q common from here, and Q is cancelled out by the Q, and therefore net capacitance for series, this is Cs, will be here. This is not Cp, this is Cs. 1 by Cs must be equal to C1, 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. In this way we can generalize our result for the n capacitor which are connected in parallel, sorry, in series and having capacitance C1, C2 and C3 and so on up to Cn, then their net capacitance 1 by Cs must be equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3 and so on, 1 by C1, 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3 and so on up to 1 by Cn. So now the next combination is parallel combination of capacitors. So here two or more capacitors are said to be in parallel whenever these capacitors are connected in between the two common points. So here you can see three capacitors having capacitance C1, C2 and C3 are connected between these two common points, and that's why these are in parallel. Or we can define parallel combination also like this: two or more capacitors are said to be in parallel whenever they are at the same potential, that is same potential is stored through them, and let Q1, Q2 and Q3 be the charge stored through the capacitor having capacitance C1, C2 and C3. Let V be the potential on each capacitor, that is C1, C2 and C3. So therefore, according to principle of conservation of charge, net charge Q must be equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. And since here Q is equal to Cp into V, and Q1 is equal to C1 into V, and Q2 is equal to C2 into V, and Q3 is equal to C3 into V. So by taking V common from the right hand side, V is cancelled out by the V, and we will get the net capacitance, that is Cp must be equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3. And if we have n capacitors, then their net capacitance Cp must be given as C1 plus C2 plus C3 and so on up to Cn. So in this way we can derive the expression for capacitance in a parallel combination. Here Cp is the equivalent capacitance of the all capacitor in parallel combination, and Q is the total charge stored, and therefore Q must be equal to, according to principle of conservation of charge, Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. That must be equal to total charge Q, and that's why we can put the value of Q, that is Cp into V, C1 into V, and then Q2, C2 into V, and then Q3, C3 into V. And now we can simplify and get our result, that is Cp is equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3. So this is the expression for net capacitance of the different capacitors which are connected in parallel, and in the same way we have been done for the capacitance of the different capacitor in series combination. So thank you, students.